Hello everybody and welcome once again to another episode of Forever Stranded. If it's not the last episode, well, I think I've got one or two more things I'd like to show you. But in this episode, what I would like to do today is to show you how to send up a space station, completed space station. Now, Nemsen did this in his own game, but he didn't show everything, so I want to show you the rest of this, what you have to do. So, let's get on with this first of all. Here you see a space station, or potentially a space station, whatever you want to build, really. And it's got some station lights here and here, and it's got a docking pad here for the rocket to land in. And here we've got a room with some oxygen scrubbers and CO scrubbers and oxygen scrubbers with power in it, and some more lighting. So it's all sort of prepared, a bit empty, really. I could put more stuff in here. For instance, it would be sensible to put in... What should we put in here? Some navigation system. So, oh, I forgot my bag actually. Have I got a guidance orientation control? That's one thing we could put into here. What else have we got in here that would be useful? Gravity controller, maybe one of those. And warp controller would be also good. But we don't really need that for the purposes of the demonstration. So you can put stuff down like this, and it can be powered up, it can be anything you like really. So if we go outside here and have a look now, you'll see at the back of this I've got some power. So I've got a fluid tank and a Stirling generator and a basic capacitor, so that's powering up this and giving us extra power at the same time. So first thing we've got to do is we need to split this up a bit. I put a launch pad all underneath this base here, and you'll see I've also marked out this. What I've done is every four blocks I've put in a line, so that's basically 16, so that's the maximum size we can send. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come along here and I'm going to knock away all of this launch pad underneath it like that. So that's then your 16, and it's not going to get interfered with the one on the other side. The reason I'm doing this is because I've had quite a bit of problems trying to set it up. Here I've got a tower, which is fine. It's around about the middle. It doesn't have to be. It can be anywhere you like. It can be at one end or another. And we'll see how we get on. So, first thing we'll do is we've got here a space station assembler. And we need to get into that space assembler some chip. So we need an unprogrammed chip. There'll be one in here, planet ID, sorry, which is the one I want. These two. I'm going to take two. And we also want a satellite container. In fact, we actually need four of these things. So let's put one of those back and keep the four. So what we need is a satellite container in here and a chip in here like that. And then we can scan it. And you'll see it's just coming down this line here. I think if we go underneath, we should see where it's actually finishing. Yes, so it's got the whole of this area in. It should have the whole of this area if we look at it from here. Yes, it is. You see it's got that block there. It disappears from time to time, but you can see the whole of it's in there. Now there's one more thing I've got to do, and it doesn't actually matter how many blocks are in, right? The limits are 16 by 16 by 64 high. I need to come down. Actually, I'll go underneath and do it from underneath. If I can get out the door. So here have we, this is the end of it. So what I want is around about the middle, which I think is around about here. It doesn't have to be, of course. I'll put in a hole there. Now, everything on this side is going to be in the first load. In fact, it's not the middle, is it? I'll put it in the middle because I like it into the middle. This is one, or one out. Put this one in here, put those two back in there like that. So what I'm going to do here is I'm now going to put a station docking port. Not a satellite bay, a station docking port. And I've got two of those prepared. That's power input, look a bit similar. These satellite bay. I can't see it for the time being. Let's just, is it this one? Yes, a station docking port. So we put one down here like that. In fact, I'll put in the floor now, but put the floor back again like that. So this is the first one we're going to send up. So that's my ID. So we'll just call it station like that. And then we're going to put another one opposite this, like this. And this one is going to be the target. So my target ID is going to be station. So this half gets up sent up first, and the second half gets sent up second. That's the idea. So we check what it says on here. So it says it's ready. So we'll build it now. And you see those two bits disappear, and it builds. Doesn't take too long. Obviously, the bigger it is, the longer it takes to build. That's why I've got this tower. It's just at the top of the height of this. You see, exactly at the same height. And when it's built, it should disappear into the station satellite bay, like that. And we get a space station chip here and a satellite bay. Now, the first thing we're going to do with this space station chip is copy it. Because you never know, you might get a game crash, whatever, and you might lose it. So you copy it by putting it into the satellite builder. Here we have a satellite builder. That's base station 3, and I want to copy that one. I think it might be this way around, actually. And then we write to secondary chip. So station is unprogrammed, and station 3 is in here. I'm not sure if it's got it the right way around or not. No, other way around. See, now it takes that one and brings it out, and we should have two space stations, 3, like that. And they're identical because they stack. Always a good idea to do that, and then put that one somewhere safely. I'm going to put it back in my advanced rocketry bag over here with the other space station 2. So now what we're going to do is we're going to send up that first part. Get it out. Did I take it out? Oh, I did. There it is. Space station chip container. Here. So I'm just going to build a quick little rocket to do this. Let's get the bits out of the bag. I actually had one prepared, but I sent it up by accident. It's only a payload, so we only need one rocket, one satellite bay, and one engine. Let's take one of these. I've got some over here as well. So let's put it down. Engine and 5 tanks. I like them. I actually like them second lights because they look better. And then on the top of that, we need to put the satellite bay. And in the satellite bay, we shall put the space station container with the space station bit in it. That's it. Now, all we need to do now is to build it. It'll scan fine. Clear for liftoff, and then we build it. You'll notice I used an advanced motor. If you look at the let's have a look if we can find it. So you got two. And this one here says it's an advanced rocket engine, but it's actually identical to the liquid-fueled one. It's supposed to give you more thrust, but it doesn't. So let's clear for lift, let's build that. Okay, and now we should be able to launch it. It should be linked, because you can see here's a line, because I link this fueling station to the rocket assembly machine and also to the rocket monitoring station. You'll see now it's full. So let's launch that into space, and there it goes. You'll notice also I've still retained the space station ID chip for station 3, because we need that for the second part of the build. So let's do that now. And this is where I got a ticking entity before. I'm not sure what the difference is, but well, let's just move this across here like that. I'll put that on the other side of this. That's gone into my rocket bag, of course, because I've got a filter on here that's collecting it in. So we want the satellite, unfortunately, rocket assembly machine, no, satellite builder, where's it gone to? PlayStation, but assembly machine, where? I can't see it. Uh-huh. There we go. Space station assembler. Like that. Check that. You'll see it's powered up. And you can actually check. This tells you it's serving two tiles, those two. So now we want to do this bit. So we've got to basically go down here and repair the floor and break this floor too. So we'll do that first. And all I'm going to do this to repair it, I'll use the builder's wand or the magic builder's wand. Let's come out here and let's get some launch pads and just put it on here like this to fill it in. Should be about 11, I think. Yeah, exactly. So now that this side is contained and it's got a structure tower here that's too small. So we'll have to make up the structure tower a bit. Let's get the structure tower bits out of the bag. Can't see them straight away, but I know they're here. You got lots of items, it's really difficult to find them sometimes. Where has he gone to? I really can't see them. Hold on a second. That is strange. They're not there. Okay, has it gone to another bag? Nope. Oh, I might be in building materials. Yes, here we go. I need some spare lights in there. They're really in the wrong bag. I have to put them in there manually. So let's press get rid of that. I will click it off. So here we've got 17. Let's just put those. Actually, I can use the builder's wand, can't I? That should be enough. Just put a torch on the top of it. The torch isn't really there for any particular reason, just decorative really. So that's the right height. And you'll see, this is very important. If you've got this wrong, you can fix it, but not when it's in the package. So you check that one, you see it's target ID station. So let's scan and build this now. So we use the same space station ID chip here and another satellite bay. And then we can scan that and you'll see it's scanning from here where it's ended last time, right over to here, which is the end of the 16 blocks here. My color coding sort of works, that's good. So you could actually carry on and build further in all directions. Maybe not vertically so easy, but the other ones are fairly straightforward. And it should say ready, and then we can build it. Ready. Now, one of the things, you see that's disappeared, and this chip's staying here, which is exactly what we want. I think I said at the beginning, I got a ticking entity here, and I'm not exactly sure what I was doing wrong. I tried it about, oh, I don't know, 10 times, eventually reported a bug. But this time I've decided I'll put it a little bit in the air, because last time it was on the same level as the ground, or as it would be, and with a bit of luck, if this builds, it works fine like that. So we have another space station container and a space station ID chip. So the next thing we do is we'll build another rocket, or I can go and have a look for that first one. Well, but it's probably just easy to build another rocket. Let's do that. Let's put the engine down and let's get out of the bag some more engines. And it doesn't matter how you place these engines actually, but and we want a satellite bay, which you've got here. Good. So I could do it the way like this. And I could put on top of here a satellite bay. Stand that out of the way, of course, and I can put into the satellite bay this space station container, and then we can build and launch it. So we can scan it. Everything's fine. All the same. Everything's exactly the same as far as I remember. Build. Now it should start to fill up as it is. And then when it needs to be full, because it only just about reaches the space station when it's not full, and there we go, launch that. So now, as you can see, off it goes. So we should now go to our own rocket here, and we should, space station one is a destination, we don't want that one. Let's let's right click that again, sorry, and press the quote key, and here's a guidance computer. Let's replace this now and put in its base station 3. So I need my gear on. Wrong bag. Where is my space station suit stuff? Here we go. Let's put that on. Take this off. Don't need those. And helmet. Okay. We're fueled up. We're ready to go. So let's go. Oh, there was the other rocket just going past. Did you see that? Well, we just went past the other rocket. So we should get to the space station before the other part of it, which is actually quite good. Space to descend, and you can see we're actually landing on the launch pad part here. I'll be curious to see what actually happens when the other piece comes into play. Now here I've set up another fueling station as well, so we could actually link this fueling station. It should be linked. There should be a docking pad under there, so let's just make sure it is linked. So just right click that there and go down here and link it to here like that. Oops, shift right click it. I think that's linked. Actually, I didn't see it say anything. Let's just double check that. No, it's not worked, has it? Shift right click. This must be the first machine to be linked, so I didn't get the other one. Oh, look! You'll see it's actually appeared as we expected it to. So I'll just carry on with this while I'm messing around. Shift right click, but the problem is when you press shift, you go down, so I don't think I got it. Well, I did put a docking pad in here, didn't I? Not a launch pad. Docking pad, yes. Well, if I can't do it that way, I'll do it the other way. The other way is simply to break the blocks underneath here like that. And then I should be able to reach it from here, like this. Rocket. Docking pad. Now, that should be linked. Let's just clear that. Okay, right. Successfully linked. So we should now see a line. Yes, we are. And we should see this now filling up with fuel. No, it's not filling up with fuel. Oops, excuse me. Let's get off this thing. Shift. So I haven't turned it on yet, I think. Or maybe it's got no power. Yes, that's its problem. Let's just quickly get some coal out. No shortage of coal. And we'll put a stack of coal in here like that. And then that'll generate some power to fill up this fuel loader. So that's now going down. Because this is turned off, let's turn this on. That activates this pipe, and then it should be filling up again, which it has done. So now the rocket should be full. Yeah. Fantastic. So we can put these two blocks back. We want to get this one actually like that, don't we? So there we have it. So here is our space station fully assembled, and the blocks in the middle have disappeared as we expect, the docking station block. So we might as well go back home now again. So that's basically it, how you build a multi-block space station, and it actually seems to be fairly robust when it's actually built, which is great. I'm just thinking, there is one more thing I'd like to show you in this reasonably short episode, and that is, I was having problems with my AE2 system. What I was doing with my AE2 system is I was running out of channels in the quantum rings. So I'm going to show you that first of all. And it's actually, I was just doing it wrong. Let's go. Fly a bit and then drop down. You see, that's my test setup. And what I was doing here is I was putting the P2P tunnels on the rings, which is not what we wanted. So let's go downstairs. That was loud. You'll see this time I've got the P2P tunnels on the controllers here, like that. So I've got P2P tunnels going through here into this. So now we can see we've got 8/6 of 8 channels going through. So we've got two more channels. These are all connected by P2P. So we've got yellow section over here, purple section, and on the other side we've got a light blue section here. They all say 6 of 8 because I could have another one going through here. The reason there's 6 is you've got 1, 2, 3 P2P tunnels on this side and 3 on the other side of the quantum ring. Let's go and have a look at that. Here, like this. Oh, interesting. So here I've got them coming out, and the P2P tunnels are on this side here. There's no controller, of course, but I'm putting them, connecting them to dense cables. So here you see we've got 8 of 32 channels being used. Here we've got, should have 19 of 32 channels. Yep. And this one has also got 6 of 8 channels. Of wrong side. Sorry. Look on this side. 6 of 8 channels. Is that right? Yeah, I think should be. Hold on, I think that's wrong. 7 of 8 channels. That's correct, because on this side of this we should have 8. This should be the 8th channel. We've got 8 processors here. So that's that. And that was where the this is connected to. So that's the other side of the P2P tunnel. And it needs power, so you need to make sure you've got a quartz fiber on this side of the thing, otherwise it doesn't get powered up and all of these then become unavailable. I could actually show you that, but I won't. And the same is true for all of these here. So you always see this connection going through here. I seem to be collecting rather a lot of don't ask me why. I didn't think it would do that. Netherwort. Right, the same is true over here, except for over here should also have power. It must have its own set of power going through here, which probably has done from these. Actually, I don't see where it's getting power from, but it's certainly got power, right? Oh, because the main power is coming from up here. I think I need to put power on here, actually. Let's just do that before I forget. Building materials, it's the applied logistics one, is this one. So this is I think that's purple, and we need a quartz fiber. So we'll put the quartz fiber on here like that, and then we can connect this up into here with some more purple cable. So I'm using smart cable always, like that, and then that will make sure that this side has got power as well. Okay, well, that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm planning another, I was planning to do one more thing with applied rocketry, but I haven't been able to speak to the developer yet to find out what that block does. But it's the, and I looked at the code, actually it says it was a multi-block structure, so I'm curious to know what the planet selector does. So until next time, bye for now.